if I attack with a sword, I can make three attacks in quick succession. But then after that, you can see the sword blinking a little bit. It goes into a short, brief cooldown. Same goes for the shield. When you block it, sometimes it will go into cooldown. This depends a little bit on the number of skills you have. If you have a good shield skill, then that will, you can block better and more powerful weapons. And also depends a little bit on the load of your opponent. Now, you can also use different weapons and different loadouts. So in this case, this character also has a two-handed sword, a long sword. It has a powerful reach and more powerful attacks, but the cooldown might also be a little bit longer. So I'm going to switch back to sword and shield. If I hold the attack button for a little while, it charges up the attack, and the attack that I'll do will be a little bit more powerful, but the penalty is that it will go, the weapon will go into cooldown immediately. So I've got some kobolds here, and they are acting aggressively, and you can see a good combat, it's important to use defense. So you can see if I aim, make sure that I'm positioned well and aimed well, I can block almost any attack with my shield. I can also use the sword to parry, and this can also have some very good benefits. But if I aim my attacks well and wait for them to, oh no, it's already scared, to after they strike, they're a little bit vulnerable, and I've got a good opportunity to strike back. The sword can also be used to do a riposte attack, which I did right now. And the way that works, I thought he was going to throw his dagger, but he didn't have a dagger. The riposte attacks, how that works is that you have to parry with your sword and then attack immediately afterwards. Now I've changed my loadout to a sword and dagger combination. The sword and dagger combination is pretty well defensive because you can use the dagger and the sword to parry, but the dagger also has a different trick. You can use it to throw, and to normally you can just stab. You can stab the dagger just as if it's a sword, but if I do a charged up attack, it will throw the dagger for a short while. There we go. That was a good use of a thrown dagger. The trouble is I have to collect the dagger myself. This will happen automatically if the combat's over, but during combat I have to retrieve the dagger myself. So the last weapon I'm going to show off in action is the two-handed sword, long sword. You might have noticed that the camera sometimes moves in closer and sometimes pulls back. There's two settings for this. Either you can have it switch automatically, so the game detects when you're in combat in close range, and it will pull in automatically, of close zoom in automatically. You can use the shift key to override that, so you can pull out or pull in when the camera is in a different position. If you go to the menu, there's always an option to change that, and then you can use the shift key as a toggle, then you have to manually toggle between the two different states. Let's see if we can fight off these creatures using the better reach of the long sword. Let's see if we can get in a power attack. Ooh, riposte. Yeah, you can see the longsword can deal a pretty hefty amount of damage.